sons of Australia, forget not your braves. Bring the wild forest flowers to strew on their graves of the four darling heroes whose race it is run, and place on their tombs wild laurels they've won. On the banks of Euroa they made their first rush. They cleared out at Coppies and they steered through the bush. Black trackers and troopers soon did them pursue, but cast out their anchor when near them they drew. Oh, the daring Kate Kelly, how noble her mien, as she sat on her horse like an Amazon queen. She rode through the forest, revolver in hand, regardless of danger, who dares bid her stand. May the angels protect this young heroine bold, and her name be recorded in letters of gold. Though her brothers were outlaws, she loved them most dear, and hastened to tell them when danger was near. But the great God of mercy, who scans all her ways, commanded grim death to shorten their days. Straightway to Glen Rowan their course did he steer, to slay those bold outlaws and stop their career. Oh, the daring Ned Kelly came forth from the inn to wreak his last vengeance. He did then begin to slaughter the troopers. Straightway did he go and tore up the railway, their train to overthrow. But the great God of mercy, to balk his intent and stop the destruction, a messenger sent, a person named Colonel, who seemed in great dread, cried out to the troopers, there's danger ahead. How the time hath its changes, how dreadful their fate. They found out their error when it was too late. The house was surrounded by troopers to score, and also expected a great many more. The daring Ned Kelly, revolver in hand, came to the veranda. The troopers he scanned. He said, you cursed wretches, we do you defy. We will not surrender, we conquer or die. Like the free sons of Ishmael, brought up in the wilds, among forests and mountains and rocky defiles, these brave lawless fellows could not be controlled, and fought 10 to 1 until death, we are told. Next day at Glen Rowan, how dreadful the doom of Hart and Dan Kelly, shut up in a room. A trooper named Johnson set the house all aflame to burn those bold outlaws. It was a great shame. And the daring Kate Kelly came forth from the crowd, and on her poor brothers she called out loud, "Come forth, my dear brother, and fight while you can." But a ball had just taken the life of poor Dan. Next morning our hero came forth from the bush, encased in strong armor, his way he did push. To gain his bold comrades, it was his desire, but the troopers espied him and soon opened fire. For the bullets bound off him just like a stone wall, his fiendish appearance soon did them appall. His legs unprotected, a trooper soon found, and a shot well directed brought him to the ground. Now he arose captured and stripped off his mail, well guarded by troopers, and taken to jail. Convicted for murder, it grieved him full sore. His friends and relations his fate may deplore. Now all you young fellows, take warning by me. Beware of bush ranging and bad company, for like many others, you may feel the darts which pierce the two Kellys, Joe Byrne and Steve Hart.